Honorable Dr. Mandeep Singh Ahluwalia, Deputy Chairman, Planning Commission of India, Professor Suresh Tendulkar, well-known economist, Sri Ajit, Sri Chandrakant Sunke, President Maharashtra Industrial and Economic Development Association, Captains of Industry, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me immense pleasure to inaugurate the Maharashtra Economic Summit, organized by the Maharashtra Industrial and Economic Development Association and the India International Trade Center. The summit has been organized at a most appropriate juncture when the state of Maharashtra is celebrating the Golden Jubilee of its establishment. I congratulate the President of the Association, Mr. Selvange, for his initiative in organizing the summit. Though this summit, the Association has created a platform for meaningful interaction on various issues relating to the development of the state. I also congratulate the Government of Maharashtra for its association with the event. Today happens to be the birthday of the late Chief Minister of Maharashtra and Deputy Prime Minister of India, Sri Y.B. Chavan, and I would like to offer my humble tributes to this great visionary son of Maharashtra. I welcome the esteemed presence of Dr. Mandeep Singh Ahluwalia in our midst today. I congratulate him for being conferred with the first Y.B. Chavan Memorial Award for Excellence in Nation Building. This is indeed a well-deserved recognition to his work as Deputy Chairman of the Planning Commission of India and as an economic advisor to the Prime Minister of India. Ladies and gentlemen, Maharashtra has been in the forefront of industrial growth and has consistently played a crucial role in the economic development of the country. The state has several natural advantages over other states. While leveraging these advantages, we need to focus on the opportunities for the sustained growth of the state. According to me, four main sectors need focused attention in Maharashtra. These are infrastructure, agriculture, industrialization, and skill development for employment generation. I will briefly elaborate on these areas in the next few minutes. Maharashtra continues to be the leading state in attracting industrial and other investments. Industries including automobiles, components, machinery, food products, processing, basic metals, pharmaceutical, gem and jewelry, and IT services have a major presence in Maharashtra. World leaders like General Motors, Volkswagen, POSCO, Bridgestone, Boeing and Duke of Education, Aviation have either set up or the process of setting up their manufacturing facilities in Maharashtra. Mumbai is state capital in the most cosmopolitan city in the country. The state has undertaken a $60 billion makeover plan for Mumbai metropolitan region on public-private partnership basis. The infrastructure projects under the Mumbai makeover plan include urban transport, roads and rail, housing, water supply, power, wastewater management, etc. These areas offer a multitude of opportunities for cooperation to the investors. Beyond Mumbai, the state is focusing on infrastructure development through large investments and increasing private involvement in smaller posts, irrigation, water supply, housing, transport and roads. Apart from the four international airports at Mumbai, Aurangabad, Nagpur and Pune, around 20 smaller airports are being developed, many of the public-private partnership basis. Maharashtra is acknowledged as a leader in the service sector, which is the largest contributor to the state GDP. However, agriculture continues to remain the stressed area of the state economy as the sector continues to offer livelihood to the largest percentage of population. The state has tremendous potential for horticulture, floriculture and food processing. We have to improve our transportation, logistics and storage facilities in this sector and tap new markets for export. This will not only increase the revenues but also create employment opportunities in rural areas. There are limitations to increasing the area under irrigation in Maharashtra beyond 30%. We therefore need innovative technologies and methods to improve our farming and enhance the agricultural production and productivity. Maharashtra has arguably the best and vast pool of human resources. As estimated, 1.5 million students are pursuing higher education in diverse streams in 19 universities in Maharashtra. The state has a large number of engineering colleges, polytechnics, industrial training institutions and other public and private education institutions which produce 500,000 skilled graduates and other technically skilled manpower every year. Many leading international institutions are partnering with Maharashtra to improve and expand skill development in technical education and vocational training. The state has tremendous potential for tourism, which needs to be exploited. We need to study the successful models of states like Kerala, Goa, Rajasthan, which attract large number of tourists. This will help us understand what more needs to be done to enhance the tourism potential of the state. To conclude, I would like to ensure this distinguished gathering, that is State of Maharashtra, is committed to putting a place and enabling atmosphere for greater trade investment and economic cooperation. I have high expectations this summit and I look forward to hearing the outcome of your deliberations. I wish the Maharashtra Economic Summit a grand success. Thank you. Jai Hind.